Okay, so next step here, now we've got a way of adding the ticket types via a drop-down menu, is to perform a count. Okay, so if I head back to here, at the moment, we've got no way of counting how many tickets are available. Okay, so we need a way of doing that, and we don't want to do it ourselves because it can get a bit difficult to count all of these. So we've got to use something called countif, okay, a formula called countif. So the way this works is I'm going to click in the box next to adult, because this is where we want the number that's been counted to appear. And we start with every formula with an equal sign. Okay, so an equal sign tells Excel that we're about to do a formula. So I'm going to type in the words countif, countif. I'm going to open a bracket. And what it's going to do is say the range. So in other words, what area do we want to count? And we want to count all of the seats. So I'm just going to highlight that area like that. Okay. So we're counting from B2 to L16. Okay, which it's done there for us. And I'm going to go up here into the formula bar just to make my life a bit easier. And I'm going to put a comma and then criteria. It's now what are we counting? So we're going to count adult tickets. Okay, so all we do is we click on the word adult like that. And a bit like if you've done some Python coding, we've always got to close the bracket. Okay, so we can do that manually like that, or we can press enter. Okay, so you can see here count if the range, so all the seats, and what are we counting every time the word adult is mentioned? N15, so N15 is adult. Okay, so I'm going to press enter, and it's counted up how many adults are in there. Okay, so I could add another adult, and it will automatically count it up for me. Same for child, click in there, equals, count if, open brackets, the range, which is the seating area, up into the formula bar, comma, criteria, so what are we counting, child this time, close the brackets, whoops, enter, okay. And then the same for none. I haven't done anything for none yet. Countif, open brackets, range, in the formula bar, comma, and the thing I want to count, which is none, close brackets. Okay. So we can just test if that works. Yep, looks like it. So that's how we perform a validation. The reason we do this is rather than allowing somebody to type something in, so let's say they type something in here but they spell adult wrong or something, okay, so it will tell us that we've done it wrong, so we can retry and then just pick from the drop down. Okay, so this is the reason why we have validation, to stop sort of, it doesn't stop all mistakes, but to minimize mistakes when we're entering data into our computer system.